Good morning, everyone. Now we are going to start chapter 3, fiber to fabric. As you all know, we all wear different kinds of fabric in different kinds of weather, depending upon our requirement, our need, and according to our comfort. In this chapter, we learn about some fibers which are obtained only from animals. The fiber which we obtained from plants that were cotton and jute, we already have done in class 6th. In class 7th, we'll study in detail about two types of animal fiber. One is wool and other is silk. As you all know, clothes protect us from wind, heat, cold, rain, and other harmful substances. Wool and silk fiber are two types of fiber which are obtained from animals. Wool is not only obtained from the sheep, but also from yak, camel, llama, alpana, goat, etc., etc., etc. So children, you will understand in detail that what is the process involved in the production of wool from the animals. Now, I'll explain you now two types of fiber. One is artificial fiber, other is natural fiber. Natural fiber, as I already told you, two type of fiber. One is plant fiber, other is animal fiber. Plant fiber, we have already covered in class 6, how the cotton is made, how the jute is extracted. Now we'll study in detail about the two types of animal fiber. First is wool and other is silk. You all know that wool is preferably worn in the winter season. And why it is worn, how we extract it, what are the steps involved in production, I'll explain you after this. Artificial fiber is a man-made fiber which is obtained by mixing two or three fibers depending upon the man's need or requirement. Suppose you wear socks. Suppose we wear different kind of undergarments or different type of clothes like raincoat, etc., etc. These are made up of nylon, polyester, terrycot, etc., etc. Fine? So, now I'll make you understand what are the different occupational hazards caused to the people working in wool or silk industry. One of the serious health hazards caused to the people working in wool industry is Sauter disease. I'm again repeating, the name of the disease is Sauter disease, which is caused to the people by a bacteria called anthrax. It is a fatal blood disease. That means it can even cause death. So the people, those are working in wool industry, have to be very, very careful. Next, because they work in the fiber throughout the day, so they mostly suffer from respiratory disorders also. You all know, you all must have heard somewhere that those people who are working in silk industry mostly suffer from skin infection and illness because they have to put their hand in the boiling water to extract the silk from the silkworm. That is why they mostly suffer, they got blister on their hands and they got skin infection. Now I am going to explain you in detail that which steps we have to follow, we have to do for extracting the wool.
In this video, we will study the processing fibers into wool. The wool which is used for knitting sweaters or for weaving shawls is a finished product of a long process. Now we will discuss the different steps that are involved in the processing of wool. First is shearing, scouring, sorting, next is removing burr, after that dyeing, and in the last the yarn is made. Now we will discuss the whole processes one by one. First process is our shearing. In this process, the fleece of our sheep along with the thin layer of our skin is removed from its body. That process is known as a shearing. This can be done with the help of machines. It's simply in the same way that we used to shave off are hair. Hair are removed during the hot weather so that sheep should not feel cool. Next step is scouring. The sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed in tanks to remove grease, dirt and dust. This process is known as scouring. Next, number three process is sorting. After scouring, what is done in the sorting? That hairy skin is sent to a factory where the hair of different textures are sorted or separated. After that, removing burr. We know burr are the small fluffy fibers that are picked out from the hair. These are the same burrs which sometimes appear on our sweaters. So after removing the burr, next step is dyeing. The fiber can be dyed in different colors. As a natural fleece of a sheep and a black is what is black, brown or white. We can dye that fibers into the different colors. Last step involved is the fibers are straightened, combed and rolled into yarn, and the long fibers are made into wool for sweaters and the short fibers are woven into the woolen clothes. So in this way, total 6 steps are involved in the process of fiber into wool.